Guys, this is a 2018 question paper. Please kindly read the question carefully so that you can understand. Once if you understand the question, you can able to solve the question. When I am solving it on the board, you can clarify all your doubts. Okay? Guys, this is a 2018 question paper, profit and loss account of Vijayalakshmi company, a partnership firm. It's not a company, it is a partnership firm. For the year ending 31st March 2019 is as follows. Cost of goods sold, as you know that it is a business expenses. Remuneration to partners is 4,49,000. See, before that, net profit is showing 2,60,000. See, whenever we have a net profit, when first step is calculation of or computation of book profit. In computing the book profit, first we should take net profit as the profit and loss account, as showing in the profit and loss account, is 2,60,000. In that, three items is to be added. One is inadmissible items, second one is partners remuneration, and third one is in excess of 12% of interest on capital. These three items we need to add. And admissible items not allowed, one item you have to deduct, and inadmissible incomes also should be deducted. So you should know the format so that we can able to easily solve it. So remuneration to partners is 4,49,000 rupees. We have taken that. Interest on interest to partners at 18% per annum is 60,000 rupees. See, the company, the partnership firm is provided 18% interest on capital, which is already deducted. But what is the provision says under section 40B is 12% is exempted and the rest of the amount is taxable. Now 60,000 is given at 18% and excess of 6% interest is taxable as 20,000 rupees. Next is municipal taxes of house property. See, municipal taxes, paying municipal taxes on house property, it is allowable as a deduction under section under the head income from house property but not from the business. So therefore it is an inadmissible item of 25,000. Other expenses, we have an adjustment. Out of other expenses, 18,400 is not deductible under section 36-38(1). So, which is not deductible, so therefore 18,400 rupees have taken. So, all the add items I have total here and we got 7,72,400 rupees. And we have one more adjustment, second adjustment. On 15th of January 2019, the firm pays an outstanding GST liability of 54,700 of the previous year 2017-18. As this amount pertained to previous year 17-18, it has not been debited to the aforesaid profit and loss account. So it means our previous year is 18-19. There was 54,700 rupees of GST liability which was not deducted, which was not taken in the previous year's profit and loss account. That means to say, previous year's profit and loss account, there was more GST or more profit, they paid more taxes. But that GST has been paid in this previous year. So whatever the GST paid last year in this year, this has to be minus from the admissible items not allowed. Okay. Apart from that, we have some inadmissible incomes as rent from house property is 60,000 and dividend is 1,70,000. See, in this question, dividend is not clearly given whether it is an Indian company or it is an income dividend from foreign company. You can assume anyways, no problem. If you assume it is dividend from Indian company, first we add it here while solving it on the gross total income. While computing income from other sources, dividend from Indian company is exempted. We can exempt also. So, but here I am assuming that dividend is from foreign company. Okay. So once if you done the book profit, we got 4,87,700 rupees. I've added these three items in less and deducted from the 4,87,700 got this book profit. Now step number two is calculation of allowable remuneration. So What is the actual remuneration we paid is 4,47,000 or statutory limit 48. Now, what is the statutory limit says is, see, if the book profit is more than 3 lakh rupees, is it more than 3 lakh rupees? Yes, it is more than 3 lakh rupees. In this, 90% of the first 3 lakhs of book profit or maximum limit of 1,50,000. In these two, which is higher? Say 90% of 3 lakhs will be 2,70,000. Definitely 2,70,000 will be greater than this. So therefore, I have taken 2,70,000. On the balance of the book profit, say on 487,700, if you deduct 3 lakh rupees, the rest of the amount is 1,87,700. On that, 60% we need to calculate. 60% is 1,12,620. Now 270 and 1,12,620, 90% of first 3 lakhs and 60% of the balance of book profit, which comes to 3,82,620. Now this 3,82,620 will be compared with the actual remuneration. Whichever is lower is an allowable remuneration. Now which is lower is 382,620 is the lower. So therefore, this amount is an allowable remuneration. Now, step number 3 is computation of gross total income. When we start calculating the gross total income, first we should calculate income from partnership firm business. Now, book profit as 4,87,700. Allowable remuneration is 3,82,620. And income from business of firm is 1,05,080. Now, in this problem, rent from house property has given as 60,000. Nowhere it is given that rent from house property is computed. If he is not given the word computed, then we take whatever the rent we collected from house property, which we call it as a gross annual value, which we have studied in income tax. Gross annual value is 60,000 less municipal taxes paid is 25,000, which is given in the. See, this is an income from house property. This is an expenses of house property. So therefore, we got a net annual value as 35,000. On this net annual value, we give deduction under section 24 as standard deduction 30% on the net annual value. And on 35,000, 30% is 10,500. And the income from house property is 24,500. Now, since we assumed the dividend 1,70,000 is received from a foreign company, I have taxed completely income from other sources. Dividend is 1,70,000. Now, income from business, income from house property, income from other sources, all put together, if you add, you get 2,99,580 rupees as gross total income of the partnership firm. Got it, guys? So, if you want to calculate, you can calculate 30% tax on this plus 3% surcharge as the total income is less than 1 crore rupees. Okay? That's all.